Andrew Mitchell felt he had no chance but to go, really, after a difficult 1922 meeting, which is a group of backbench Tory MPs who met on Wednesday and discussed for half an hour his future. He had a report from that afterwards, and I think he felt that his authority as chief whip, this sort of intangible thing that he needs to be chief whip to keep all the MPs in check, had really disappeared almost completely, and he was left with little choice but to go. He felt last night, I'm told, that he had to resign, and he resigned today on Friday to the Prime Minister at Chequers. I think there's a feeling that it was going towards an end game because it's 1 month today since the incident occurred. It was a surprise he was going today. It was Friday night, but I suppose it was the way it had to work because it was a natural pause between the two political weeks. The next week starts on Sunday, and Mr Cameron had been away in Brussels overnight and had not got back into Britain until early afternoon, and that's why they met at 4 o'clock. Mr Mitchell was a dead duck, really, almost the moment the story came out, because it cut right through to the chase. It was Labour were telling people that it was an issue, even at the Corby by-election next month, that the issue of calling anyone a pleb and swearing at the police, I know he denied the pleb, but he missed the swearing, those two actions were seen to be disrespectful to public service people who protect the politicians, and whether or not he used the derogatory term, he denied it. It seemed to stick and seemed to be what people thought the Tories were like, and that's why it had such resonance outside this kind of Westminster village that we work in.